Steve round the corner to the right. Alex couldn't help but wonder where Steve was going with his path. Were they going to get jumped by mobs? Were gas going to ruin their route again? Will their fire resistance effects run out too soon? Without knowing the answer, Alex followed him anyways. They passed through a well of lava and a small netherwart farm. Climbing up the staircase, Alex puts up her bow, surprised to see that Steve wasn't as cautious. He simply ran up the staircase, only glancing back to check for intruders. Alex was entirely different. She took her time, keeping her strength ends and her arrow ready. She slowly rotated around the room, checking for any slight tinge of suspicion. Come on. What are you waiting for? Steve yells, already 30 blocks ahead. Alex rolls her eyes and catches up to him. You shouldn't be so careless about this. Alex berates, relaxing her best ring. And you shouldn't be so slow. We have to get there before we run out of time. Alex only rolls her eyes again, simply pushing aside her feelings of rebellion to the back of her mind. They continue running down the hallway past 10, 11 intersections. WH, where are we going? Alex manages to get out in between breaths. She puts her hands down on her knees, practically wheezing for air. Steve rolls his eyes, mocking Alex. Perhaps Steve isn't so amateurish. What? You tired already? Come on. I only have a minute left of my fire resistance. Steve rushes down the final intersection, finally seeing the look of another exit. This time revealing the other side of the Nether Fortress. Da. There they are. The human excitedly points down the nether brick structure, showing a collection of branches and nether fences. Spawners. Alex couldn't keep up. She just had to take a breather. No, don't go, without me. She coughs. Steve ignores her and rounds the large bridge corner, ready to take on the blazes he was about to encounter. Unfortunately, the pigman was still aggro. A guard looks at Steve and snarls, his golden sword shining in the ghost-tone light. More pigmen join the stare down that was taking place, all in the ready position. The zombie pigmen were set to attack, and Steve knew it perfectly well. He springs down the bridge, his eyes set for the prize. The pigmen spring to action, as they begin their barrage of mishaps and swings. Alex was watching from the distance, amazed at Steve's dodging. Steve sprints ahead to his first blaze, who he pinned down and mercilessly hacked through. Good, just 5 more to go. Steve rolls in a patch of souls and dodges the incoming fire. Immediately springing up, he swings at the blaze, who floats to the side to avoid the diamond blade. 2 more blazes joining. A fireball directly hits Steve in the leg, causing him to wince from impact, but not a fire. The other 2 land on his back, lowering his health even more. His resistance was about to run out, and Alex was not much of a help. Grunting at Alex's laziness, Steve propels himself off of a nether brick ledge to spring high up in the air, giving him enough force to critically damage on one of the blazes. Steve hops up and pokes the blaze above, which dropped another blaze rod. 10 seconds of fire resistance, he thinks, taking on the blaze directly next to the one he just killed. He feels a sharp stab in the back, and his health drained down yet again. Alex! Steve screams at the top of his virtual lungs. He really needed her help just about now. Too bad he didn't bring a bow, or else this job would be done and over with a long time ago. The last bit of his fire resistance faded away, and he was met with the licking flames of fire on his back. He couldn't help but scream in pain, causing his sword slashes to miss terribly. The blazes began to fly higher up, leaving Steve to suffer. Where was Alex? Getting desperate, Steve searches in his inventory that could put out the fire. Why didn't they bring any extra fire resistance potions? Steve looks up at the blazes in the sky, circling him as if they were taunting him. He kneels on the ground, melting down to his final 3 hearts. An arrow flies up and hits a blaze right in the head. It falls straight to the ground right after. Alex! Alex! She shoots the other blaze, but it misses, hitting a ghost-tone crystal instead. The hanging light disconnects from the netherrack ceiling, causing it to shatter on contact. The redhead chucks a splash potion at Steve. Steve was going to die. It's a harming potion, isn't it? It's over, she won. Steve hears the glass crack, anticipating his upcoming death. Except he didn't die. Steve opens one eyelid. Wait, he isn't dead. Instead of what he thought was his obvious, upcoming end, he got the feeling of regeneration. She actually helped him. Why? Realizing what she had just done, Steve stands up and picks up the diamond sword he dropped. Alex was firing away at the other blaze that she missed. Hitting it, it falls down the fortress. Alex snags it before it falls into the sea of lava below. Phew. She exhales in relief. Aghast flings a fire charge at the two. Reflexively, Steve tackles Alex to the ground, the hot projectile flying right above them. She looks up, a bit startled that Steve would actually do something to save her. Well, both of them were questioning that as well. Did they really want each other to live? Did they want the other to live in the same world? They didn't think so, but they did anyways. Maybe this was the unintentional start of a rather reluctant friendship. Come on. I have 5 blaze rods, you have 1, right? Steve asks. Alex holds up the blaze rod she caught. Nodding enthusiastically, Steve grabs her hand. Then let go. Alex yelps as Steve takes her all the way to the entrance of within the Nether Fortress. Why did you have to drag me here? She hisses, yanking her hand away from Steve's. Because that. Steve points at the buzzing wave of blazes that were their way to the entrance. Now we need to go now, an explosion blasts the two back against the wall. What? A hole was carved out of the tunnel, and a ghast was looking straight into it. A zombie pigman with a leather helmet sat on top of it, seemingly piloting it around. Go, go, go. Steve instinctively grabs Alex's hand again, taking her down the halls. Blazes began to pour into the gaping hole, but luckily, the humans were far from them now. I think we're fine. Alex says, letting go of Steve's hand. Oh, sorry, he smiles sheepishly, putting a hand behind his neck. Force of habit, Alex rolls her eyes. Doesn't matter, let's go. She runs ahead of him. Fire charges from the blazes shot down the hall like arrows, whizzing past them at incredible speeds. It was a miracle they weren't hit by any. Equals this way. Alex rounds an intersection, getting away from the cloud of blazes in the main hall escape. Hopefully we can find a way out of this. But unfortunately, they weren't. Instead, they were greeted with a group of zombie pigmen.